What's going on, guys? Well, recently I solicited questions on Twitter. You guys sent a bunch in. I'm not gonna be able to get to all of them, but I picked ones that actually get asked often, and that way it can help the most people out. So let's go ahead, get started. Kyle Rose wants to know if he can take audio from his Rode mic T2i and then sync it with another camera in iMovie. Absolutely, you can do this. The key is you need to detach your audio in iMovie. So just select your clip, right click, detach audio, and then your audio track and your video track will act independently of each other, and you can, you know, cut and splice and do everything you want to, intercut between the two different cameras, and it should be pretty easy for you to set it up after that. Jacob Milligan 1 wants to know if Final Cut 10 is worth the upgrade from iMovie. And it's a little bit of a controversial question, and here's what I always tell people is that, you know, all things being equal, I'm willing to bet you did not get everything you can out of iMovie. People want to move on from iMovie too soon, I think, and that's why I try to make a lot of videos showing you all the capabilities of iMovie. So I always say stick with iMovie as long as you possibly can. And, you know, once you get every last ounce of usefulness out of it, then yeah, Final Cut is definitely going to be a great upgrade for you, and I'd 100% recommend it when you're at that point when you're ready to move on to something more advanced. Mr. Plague asks where and how I met my fiance. We actually met in Korea. We were both stationed there when we were in the Air Force. And I'm actually in her office right now, so that's why things look a little more feminine in this video than they normally do. And for you guys that don't know, she actually has a pretty popular craft art design blog. I'll put a link down below so you guys can check it out. VV Austin SVV wants to know what my current plans are for my Matt's Macintosh channel and my favorite moment in high school. To answer the high school one first, that's too hard to say. I had a great time in high school, so it'd be really hard to pick just one moment. As for the channel, you know what, my plans is that, you know what, I'm gonna keep doing it as long as I'm having fun with it. So as long as it's something enjoyable for me to do, I'm gonna keep it up. So whether that means I'm gonna still be doing Matt's Macintosh videos when I'm 90, maybe so, as long as I still love it, that's kind of my barometer for whether I keep doing it or not. Atigo13 has a 550D, that's a T2i for all us American guys. Shoots a lot of videos with it. His friends are telling him that's gonna wear down the picture quality. That is 100% not true. And this is assuming you're not shooting lasers down the lens or something when you're making the videos. What is actually gonna wear down your camera is taking still pictures. Because the most easiest part to break on cameras is the shutter. And that's what goes out before any other aspect of your camera will. And that's why when people buy used cameras, they always look for low shutter count cameras. So that shutter is gonna go out from taking still pictures long before your sensor is gonna get burnt out from you taking video. So take all the videos you want to. Azax456 asks if I have any kind of formal video training. Absolutely not, and you can definitely tell in some of my stuff. Especially, you can actually go back and see when I learned how to do stuff in my YouTube videos, because you'll see, like, in my early videos, I basically know nothing, and then, like, you know, I learn more and more as I go along. So no formal training at all. Of course, many of you guys know I am going to film school pretty soon here. I quit my normal job to go to school full-time. So I will have some formal training soon, but as of right now, I'm just kind of making it up as I go. Mobile Doms, buying a Mac Mini from old ones from different parts, putting a new one together, wants some advice. I would say the first thing I would do is go to the iFixit website and look at their teardown of the Mac Mini. And that way you can see what you're getting into. Because in the Mac Mini, especially if you're talking an older modern Mac Mini, for sure, it's difficult to get to some of the components in it. I mean, you're gonna have to move antennas, all kinds of stuff. So you need to be prepared to do that before you go and start buying all these parts, because otherwise you might not know what you're getting yourself into. And finally, PT Bruno C wants to know if I know how to say hello and thank you in Portuguese. Of course I do. You say it just like this, right?
Olá, obrigado.
So that's it for this round of questions and answers, guys. Thanks so much for everyone who sent them in. Sorry I couldn't get to everyone. You can always leave a comment, send me an email, tweet me if you've got something you want to know. I'll try my best to get back to you. Thanks for watching, guys. I'll see you next time.